of students. We're going to do some introduction material to logarithms. We'll learn what a logarithm is and how it applies to exponentials and inverse functions, some previous lectures that we did. So first off, what we want to try to do is figure out what a logarithm is, how we define a logarithm, and then try to understand how we're going to apply it to evaluating expressions, solving equations with exponentials, and graphing, and learn some of their unique properties. So a logarithm, what we want to note is that every exponential function which I usually denote as exp has an inverse function called a logarithm. Okay, that's how we're going to define logarithms. They're nothing more than inverse exponential functions. So what you want to do is recall, if we had a function that was like y equals 2 to the x, okay, we learned about these exponential functions. This function has an inverse which is made by interchanging the x and the y. Okay, so here is the inverse of this function, which is a log function. So we say log for short when we talk about logarithms. It's a lot less to say. So which is a log function? Log base 2 of y equal to x. Log base 2 of x equals y. Alright, so this same exponential function can be represented as a log function in this way. Okay, there's a little pattern to it that you want to learn and be able to translate exponentials to logs and logs to exponentials. So this is how it's tied into the inverse exponential definition. Really important stuff. So what we like to think of with logarithms, so logs, are a system developed to work with inverse exponentials and apply them to the main things we want to do, apply them to evaluating expressions, solving equations, with exponentials or logs. So these are my short for exponential or logs. And then, of course, graphing. And then there's some application problems that come into play as well. So those are our main purposes here. So what we want to do is logs have unique properties that we will apply to all of the above. And these properties come from the fact that they are inverse exponential functions. Okay, so now that we did a quick little intro on what a logarithm actually is and how it's tied into something that we know, have experience with, let's go ahead and look at the general form of a logarithm. And we want to understand the general format of a log and then be able to see how we could rewrite it as an exponential and work with them. Okay, so the general form so we could say y, or since it's a function, we'd say f of x equals log base a of x. Okay, and there's a certain way we write this and say this. Now this is always a subscript, so it's a little, the base value, which is our a value, is always written below the log and the inside of the log, called the argument. So a, where a is the base of the logarithm, and we have some restrictions on a. A is positive. It's a positive real number, and a cannot equal to 1. There's certain restrictions applied, and we'll understand more of these restrictions when we convert this to exponential form. Okay, so where a is the base of the logarithm, and this has to be a positive real number, not equal to 1. Then we also have, clear my a, we also have restrictions on our x. X is our independent variable. And as we know, x has to be something that cannot be 0 or a negative. So x not equal to 0 or be negative. This is our domain restriction. So logarithms, depending upon how the inside of the logarithm is set up, will have certain domain restrictions on them. Okay, so it cannot equal 0 or be negative, so it must be, x must be greater than 0. That's a concise way of saying that. Okay, very important. And the other part we know is that f of x is our output, or our dependent variable. And our output will always be positive, depending upon if we have other numbers that are subtracted. So that I'll just say that's our dependent variable, our output. These are really important ideas here. So this is our base. This is our input. And this is our output. Okay. So, let's see. Now this stems from, and we'll get to this property a little later, it stems from a property built into logs that say if you have a base a to the log base a of x is equal to x. So this property comes into play in this definition. Okay? So here's our general form for a logarithm. So what we note is the form in exponential form this translates to a to the y power equals x. So this is the exponential equivalent. Okay, really important. So these are two ways of writing the same thing. So this is your exponential equivalent slash exponential form. And then this right here is your log form. Okay, there's your log form. This is your exponential form. So there's a lot of background noise at the moment. Okay, so what we have next is a little trick that we'll look at on converting this. But what we first want to know when base A is equal to E, we use something called a natural logarithm. Okay, so let's go ahead and define these natural logs. So what we have are natural logarithms, which we denote by ln, or in lowercase ln. And we use the natural log when the base is a value e, which is approximately 2.7. Okay, so when the base of the log is a equal to e, we use ln instead of the log. Okay, ln instead of log to write it out. So our general form in that case will be y or f of x equals ln base e of x. So this is our natural log form, which can be written as an exponential form. E to the y equals x. Okay, so these are two equivalent ways of saying the same thing again. The only difference between the ln again and the log is the fact that you have e being your base. So what you want to recall is that e is approximately equal to 2.7. Okay, e is equal to 2.7. Now, one thing that I want to note is the way this is read. So just a note on how to read these, how to transcribe these. Our general log form, when you have f of x or y is equal to log base a of x, is stated as log base a of x. So that's how you would literally read the statement right here. So this is written as, or stated as log base a of x. So really important little factor when you're transcribing logarithms. The other thing is, a little thing on conversion, converting to exponential form. Here's a little trick that I use, and the trick is I remember Bob, and Bob means a base. You always start with your base when you're converting. Base, over, and back. Okay? So one of the first things we're going to do is convert logarithms exponentials to logarithms and then convert logarithms back to exponentials. So you want to be very fluent in being able to do that so that you could apply it to graphing, evaluating, and solving equations. So here we have exercises. And the first set of examples we'll do is number one, rewrite the following exponentials into logarithms. So all we're doing is converting, rewriting. So number one, base over back, we start with the base is a number base, and we say log base 2 of 8 equals 3. So this is where your base goes. Here's your base. You go over the equal sign, and then you go back. And now you have two equivalent expressions. You have your exponential and your log expression. So here you have your exponential form, which is equal to your log form. Two ways of expressing the same thing. Two, if we had something like, let's see, 4 to the x equals 9. If all we want to do is convert it, we do the same thing. We say log base 4 of 9 equals x. Base over back. And let me write one more. Let's say we had 10 to the 5 equals x minus 1. The same applies. This is a base, that's a number. So we say log base 10 of x minus 1 of the whole thing on the other side equals the entire exponent. Okay. So here again we have our exponential form, and here we have our log form. And these are equivalent. And one more, what happens when I have a base that's an e? If I had something like e to the x plus 1 equals 7. In this case, this base, which is a number between 2 and 3, it's 2.7, Euler's number. In this case, we use natural logs. Okay, so when it is a base e, we write this as a natural log, which is ln base e of 7 equals x plus 1. So these two are equivalent. So this is your exponential form. And this is your log, or we could call this our natural log form, or ln form. Same thing. Now, some things to know is in a lot of cases, these are not written, these bases. So when it's just written as a log, it's understood to be 10. Something to remember in working with logarithms. For ln, it's always understood to be e. So we don't need to write them in all the time. That's an understood value. So let's go ahead and do a second set. And let's go the other way. Let's take something that is in logarithm form and write it in exponential. Let's write the following logarithms into exponential
same mnemonic again. Bob, base, over, and back. And this becomes 2 to the 3 equals 8. Okay, same system. So log form exponential. Log in your exponential form. 2, if you had ln of, let's say, x plus 3 equals 7, what you have to realize is that there's an understood e here. So that when we write it in exponential form, this becomes e to the 7 equals x plus 3. So here we have our log or ln form, and that's equivalent to its exponential form. Two ways of writing the same thing. So it goes both ways. So you definitely want to know how to convert every log to an exponential, every exponential to a log. And what we'll cover next is we'll look at properties of logarithms. We'll look at how to evaluate them. There's some that you can evaluate by knowing how the exponents work easily. There's some that are not so easy. And then we'll look at solving exponential log equations and looking at their graphing properties. All right, that's it for a little intro today, and we'll look for a series of more logarithmic functions and looking at their properties in the future.